the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who made of the Saint Bernard a man consumed with zeal for your house, and a light shining and burning in your church, grant through his intercession that we may be on fire with the same spirit and walk always as children of light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the beginning of the Book of Ruth. Once in the time of the judges, there was a famine in the land. So a man from Bethlehem of Judah departed with his wife and two sons to reside on the plateau of Moab. Elimelech, the husband of Naomi, died, and she was left with her two sons, who married Moabite women, one named Orpah, the other Ruth. When they had lived there about 10 years, both Mahlon and Chilion died, and the woman was left with neither her two sons nor her husband. Then she made ready to go back to the plateau of Moab, because word reached from her there that the Lord had visited his people and given them food. Orpah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye, but Ruth stayed with her. Naomi said, "See now, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and her God. Go back after your sister-in-law." But Ruth said, "Do not ask me to abandon or forsake you. For wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God." Thus it was that Naomi returned with the Moabite daughter-in-law Ruth, who accompanied her back from the plateau of Moab. They arrived in Bethlehem at the beginning of the barley season. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, praise the Lord, my soul. Praise the Lord, my soul. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is the Lord his God, who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them. Praise the Lord, my soul. The Lord keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. Praise the Lord, my soul. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects the stranger. Praise the Lord, my soul. The fatherless and the widow he sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever. Your God, O Zion, through all generations. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, my soul.
Teach me your paths, my God, guide me in your show. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. I read it from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus was silent, that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, He got her together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your souls, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord. It is impossible to do one thing without the other. This is a well-used phrase, and each one of us may have a particular example in mind when we hear it. Jesus says the same thing to us today, but with different words. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments. We cannot truly love. We cannot truly love God if we do not love our neighbor. And we cannot truly love our neighbor if we do not love God. And now let us turn to the Lord with our petitions. For the church, may the Lord continue to bless her with a fortitude in her protection of the unborn and the dignity of all human life. Let us pray to the Lord. For leaders throughout the world, and for the prosperity and peaceful coexistence of all people, let us pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here, especially parishioners of St. Zach, and for those who are part of our community but unable to be present with us today, let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died marked with the sign of faith, may they rejoice forever with God in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord. God of all power and compassion, we pray that you accept these prayers that requires of blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, God of creation, for the goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and fruit of human hands, and will become our spiritual being. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. We offer to your majesty, O Lord, the sacrament of unity and peace as we celebrate the memorial of Saint Bernard, a man outstanding in word and deed, who strove to bring order and concord to your church through Christ the Lord. Lord, be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is through right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in life, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with hope, and so with all the angels and saints we praise you. As in our land, I pray. Lord, You are in the holy Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving that thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving a thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving a thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be God and be one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis Pope and Blaise and Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Lord, we die in mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, St. Zachary, with St. Bernard, and all the saints that please you, God the ages, we may merit to be coerced in your life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the name of God for his Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and fortified by teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
Lamb of God.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God.
about it?
Amen.
What about it?
Amen.
What about it? What about it? What about it? What about it? May the food we have received, O Lord, as we honor St. Bernard, the work its effect in us, so that strengthened by his example and instructed by his teaching, we may be caught up in love for the incarnate Word, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.